Let us now move on into the question number 6 of your book back exercise problem in the first unit electrostatics. The question is, consider an electron traveling with the speed of V naught and entering into an uniform electric field E which is perpendicular to V naught. Ignoring the gravity, obtain the electron's acceleration, velocity and position as function of time. So what is the question given here is, an electron is traveling with the speed V naught. So you have an electron moving with the speed V naught and it is entering into the electric field. So this electric, for this electric field, it is perpendicular to the V naught. So if the V naught is along the x direction, the electric field should be pointing towards the y direction. So which is perpendicular. As it is perpendicular, the charges will be parallel to each other and you can see that the electric field is pointing outwards from the positive charge and it is ending up in the negative charge. So we have to find the acceleration, velocity and position of the electron within this electric field. So let me go in with the acceleration first. So in acceleration, A is given by the term A vector. This can be written as in the component format as Ax I cap plus Ay j cap. So you have to find the x component and the y component for the electron for the acceleration part. So Ax and Ay. In this case, the velocity is constant. It is moving with the constant, the electron is moving with the constant velocity along the x direction. So if the velocity is constant along the x direction, acceleration is nothing but change in velocity by change in time. So my acceleration Ax would be d by dt of any constant value. Differentiation of any constant value is simply 0. So x component of the acceleration value is 0 here. Next, go in for the y component. To find the y component, let me take it as the force is given by m into Ay on the electron by which it moves. And the force with respect to the electric field, I can write it as Q into E. The charge value Q, what is the charge value Q here? Q equal to N into E, we know that. And how many electrons are moving here? Only one electron. So my N value is simply 1. So Q is equal to 1 into E, which is simply E. So instead of Q, you can simply write it as E. So my F is minus E into E here. As it is electron, you have to go for minus E value. So you have two force values here. By equating 1 and 2, you have left hand sides are equal, so right hand side you can be equating. So MAY equal to minus EE. And this AY is what we needed. So Ay is equal to, bring this m to the other side, you will be getting as minus Ee by m. So this is the y component of acceleration, this is the x component of acceleration. So for total acceleration, it should be x component I cap plus y component into j cap. X component is 0, y component is minus Ee by m into j cap. So this is my acceleration value. 0 minus anything is simply minus. So my A value is, acceleration A for the electron is minus Ee divided by m into j cap. So next we'll move on into the velocity part. So to find velocity, it is again Vx I cap plus Vy j cap. So to find velocity, I'm going to take the equation V equal to u plus at. So again for the x term, x component, it is vx is equal to ux plus ax into t. And we know the ax value is 0. So this term would become 0. Then vx is equal to ux, which is the initial velocity here. Ux is the initial velocity, which is simply v naught. And y, for y component, vy equal to uy plus ay into t. The initial velocity in the y component, because the velocity is, the electron is moving along the x direction and not in the y direction, so velocity along y direction is 0. So you have ay term, and the value of ay we have found as minus ee by m into t. So my final velocity, that is vy value, is equal to simply minus em by t. So then, so the total velocity v is equal to vx I component I vector plus vy j vector. And we know that vx is simply v naught I vector, and for y component it is minus em by m into t j cap. So this is my total velocity for the electron. Next, moving on with the position, it is displacement, and it is given by s is equal to ut plus half at square by the equation. So again, this has to be written as x component and y component. So s is equal to sx I cap plus sy j cap. So find the x component and y component. For x component, sx is equal to uxt plus half axt square. As we know, ax term is 0. And for ux, the initial velocity is v naught. So the sx component is sx is equal to v naught into t. And for y component, sy is equal to uy t plus 1 by 2 ay t square. So sy is equal to uy t plus half ay t square. And the velocity along the y value is 0, so it is 1 by 2, and a value is minus ee by m into this t square. So my sy component is minus 1 by 2 ee by m into t square. So the total displacement would become s is equal to sx I cap plus sy j cap, which is simply sx value is v naught t, sy value is minus 1 by 2 ee by m t square j cap. This is here, you have to give the I cap here. So this is the displacement of the electron.